Hello everybody and welcome back to another Blender Manages tutorial. Today we're going to be looking at the fluid simulation and the object control or the type control. So I have not seen a lot of tutorials on this, so I decided to make one of my own. Now what the control object does, it kind of controls the simulation and water kind of forms around it, and I'll show you what I mean in just a little bit. But this is actually a plug for a course that I just came out with called the Blender 3D Fluid Simulation Guide. And I show you guys exactly what this simulation is about, how to use it, what all the settings do. We look at the domain settings, we look at the different types like fluid type, inflow, outflow, all those, the particle, stuff like that. And then at the end, there's three different tutorials in which we create an entire scene using the simulation. So if you want to go check that out, link is down in the description. Alright, so let's get started with the tutorial. So this cube right here is going to be our domain. So I'm going to go into edit mode and I'm going to move it up so the origin point is at the bottom. So press G, Z, 1 and enter. So now the origin is right there. And now if we're in object mode and we scale up, we can see that it goes up instead of down. And that's what we want. Alright, so go into front view and then press 5 to go into orthographic view. We'll scale this up right about here or so. Yeah, probably somewhere around there. Scale it along the X just a little bit as well. There we go, that looks pretty good. Now I'm going to press Shift D on this cube. So Shift D, and this is going to be our fluid. So right click, and then press S, Z, and scale it down till it's about right there or so, probably. Then press S, Shift Z, and bring it in just a little bit so the edges are not touching the domain, the edges right there. So make sure you bring it up. Somewhere right here is probably good. Great. Alright, so now what we're going to do is press Shift A. I'm going to add in a UV sphere, and this is going to be our control object. So bring it down right about here, and what we're going to do is animate this so it goes up right here and then it kind of explodes, and I'll show you guys exactly how to do that. So first I'm going to right click on this and I'm going to change this to a fluid. So go over to the physics, click on fluid, and set the type to just regular fluid. We don't have to worry about any of these settings, but we want to next right click on this, go to fluid, and set the type to domain right here. Now last right here, fluid, and set the type to control. So now let's talk about these options here. First off, we have the start and end frame. So basically what this is it's in seconds, and what it does is it takes a real life simulation and it stretches a 4 second real life simulation and it stretches it over 250 frames, or the amount that you say right here. So I want to set this to a value of 120 right here. And now I'm not going to worry about this because I kind of want it to be in a little slow motion. So you could go over to like here, change this to the FPS that you want, the frame rate, and then do some multiplication to get it really accurate. But I'm not going to worry about that because we don't need to do that. The reverse frames, what this just does is it reverses the frames. It's pretty easy to understand. Now the quality, you want to be careful with this setting because sometimes it can go really high. Like if you set to 100, it's going to go really, really slow. The baking will take a really long time. So you just want to be careful with that. If we hover over it, you can see the quality, which is used for the object sampling, higher but slower. So I'm going to set this to a value of 15. Now let's talk about the attraction force. So the strength, this is how strong it is like attached to the object. If we hover over it, you can see that the force for directional attraction towards the control object. So it's the strength of the attraction to the control object right here. The radius, this is kind of like a force field around the radius, or around the object, I mean. So if we set this to a high number, like 2, it's going to be, the water is going to be somewhere around here. It's not going to be really close. But if we want it really close, then we want it to, like, we want to set it to like a 0.2 or something like that. The velocity force, I'm not exactly sure how this works. I've messed around with it, and the only thing that I could really tell is just how fast the simulation goes, I think. I'm not exactly sure. So if you guys know what the velocity force does, please tell me in the comments. All right, so now what we're going to do is animate this, and we're going to animate the strength as well. So drag the sphere down below the water, and I'm going to hit I and set a location keyframe right here on frame 1. We're going to go to frame 50, and we're going to drag it through the water right about here, and I'm going to hit I and hit location one more time. Now what we want to do is animate the strength, and what this will allow us to do, it will create like an explosion effect. So we're going to set the strength to 0.5, and we're going to go to frame 60 and then hover over the strength icon and hit I. This will add a keyframe to this. Next, go to frame 65, and we're going to change this to a negative value, so negative 0.5. This will push the water away and not bring it forward. So hit I over the strength, and this will allow it to do that. So now all we have to do is do some baking stuff over here. I'm going to change the resolution to 120, and I'm going to leave the time as it is. I'll change the view to final so we can actually see what it looks like in the viewport. I'm going to come down here, and the generate, normally I would add some generate particles, but for the control object, I found that particles don't really work that well. I'll show a video, an animation on screen right now, that the particles, it kind of just goes everywhere if we add some. So I'm going to leave the particles off. I don't need to worry about that. The smoothing, we could change this to 1.2, I guess. And we'll leave the subdivisions at 0. That's perfectly fine. So make sure you set a cache output right here. You can set it wherever you want. Once you do that, hit Control S, save your Blender file, and hit Bake. Okay, the baking has finished. And so now if we scroll through this, we can see exactly what it looks like. There you go. And you can see that the water is kind of enveloping the UV sphere, and that's looking really cool. And then once we come over here, you can see that the explosion effect just pushes all the water away just like that. Awesome. Okay, so now what we're going to do is right click on this fluid and just press M and move it to layer 2. And then right click on this, press M and move it to layer 2 as well. So now it kind of looks like just water floating and then boom, explosion. Just like that. Perfect. I'm going to right click on this and hit smooth shading so everything's a little bit smooth. Yeah, that looks a little bit better. Now let's do the material. So come over to the material tab, click new, and I'm going to change this to a glass shader. So in the course, I describe what the IRR and what the difference is and all that type of stuff. Basically what the IRR means is how light passes through it and it kind of morphs, and it's a little bit complicated, but I'm going to change this to 1.33. That is the index of refraction for water, and that's what we need to set right there. We also need to make sure that this is set to white, so drag this all the way up to white. And now let's press Shift Z to see exactly what this looks like. We can't really see it because there's no plane, so I'm gonna press Shift C to snap my cursor to the center. Press Shift A, I'm gonna add in a plane. I'm gonna scale it up right about here or so. And I'm going to go into edit mode, right click on this, extrude it up by pressing E and then Z to lock it. And then I'm going to add in a subdivision surface modifier. So go add a modifier, subdivision surface, turn both of these up to 6. And then go into edit mode, hit Control R, add a loop cut, and just drag this in so the corner is a little bit tighter right there. Great. This is going to be a mix shader, so go here and go mix right here, and diffuse and glossy. We're going to change the factor of this mix shader to a value of 1, or 0.2. Yeah, 0.2, and I'm going to change roughness down to a value of 0.05. If we look at the preview, we can see exactly what this looks like. That looks pretty good. I'm gonna right click on this, and this is going to be a sun lamp. And I'm gonna rotate it and just place it right about here or so. Drag this up somewhere around there is probably good. Go into front view, and I'm going to place the camera right about here. So hit Control Alt 0, and I'll right click on this camera. I'll drag it back a little bit, drag it up maybe, rotate X. Something around here is probably good. And then we'll scroll through this and just make sure everything looks good. Maybe drag it up a little bit. Right about there. There we go. Okay, so I'm going to press Shift Z to see what this looks like now. Nice, that looks pretty cool. Okay, so now I'm going to come over here and I'll do a little bit of render sampling stuff. So go into the sampling, change the indirect to a value of 1. This will help get rid of any white speckles across our image. Go into the light paths, turn off reflective and refractive caustics. This will also help. And I think we're ready to do a render. So save your project, Control S. And one last thing, actually, I'll drag this up a little bit so it's not so dark. And then I will hit render. So I'll see what this looks like and I'll be right back. Okay, the render has finished and this is our result. So look at that. That looks really cool. So you guys, you can create this into an animation. I'll put a link down in the description on a tutorial that I did where I show you how to create an animation, what all the things you need to do, the output, video sequence editing, all that stuff. Link is down in the description. And remember to go check out my course that I created on the fluent simulation. That's also linked down in the description. Well, that's going to be it for this video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next tutorial.